Good morning, students. I hope everyone is safe at home. So successfully you completed two lessons. So today is our third lesson, ankle tissues. So already we discussed what is a cell and what is a tissue. So cell is the basic structural and functional unit of an organism. So what is a tissue? The tissue is the combination of identical cells. A group of similar cells perform similar function is called as tissue. A group of identical cells or similar cells perform similar function, same function is called as tissue. For example, you take our liver cells. So liver, the liver is the largest organ in our body, largest gland. So it is made up of hepatic cells. So if you see these hepatic cells, all cells are, this is the all cellular, they are identical in their shape. Like that, you take nerve tissue. So nerve is a cell, nerve neuron. So if you see, they all are looking like this. So easily you can identify them. Like that, now we discuss the cells. Cells then form tissues. Tissues form, so these tissues, various kinds of tissues, they form the organs. They form the organs. So these organs are formed, organ systems. And organ systems, they form organism. Organ systems, they form the organisms. Organisms, they form the community, community to population, like that the process goes on. But the life, the process starts with the cell. The group of cells, they form the tissues. Tissues form the organs. Organs form organ systems. So the combination of organ systems is nothing but the organism. The combination of organ systems, you see our body contains so many organ systems. Respiratory system, circulatory system, digestive system, excretory system, nervous system. So these are reproductive system. So many organ systems are there. So these are all organ systems, they put together form the organism. Okay, this is the organization of life. So here today we are going to discuss about the what are animal tissues. So like plants, animals also, they have the four major type of tissues. They have four major type of tissues. The first one is called as the epithelial tissue. Epithelial. Epithelial tissue. Connective tissue. Muscle tissue, and fourth one, nerve tissue. These are the four major types of tissues: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscle tissue, and the nerve tissue. So first we'll discuss about the epithelial tissue. So what is the main function of the epithelial tissue? Epi means outer. So the main function of the epithelial tissue, it forms the outer lining of the cells and the organisms. That is called the main function of the epithelial tissue. For example, you see our skin. The skin is the longest epithelial tissue in our body. So the skin is the longest epithelial tissue. So now we'll discuss what are the functions of this epithelial tissue. Now we will discuss what are the functions of this epithelial tissue. So epi means outer. So first we will discuss about the epithelial tissue. So for this, just you conduct an experiment. Simply I will explain, you listen the experiment. So take a skin of the hen. Hen's skin you take and dilute. Just you soak in the dilute HCl or vinegar for 2 to 3 hours. Then what will happen? It will become soft. The skin will become soft. Then take the skin and keep it on a slide. Keep it the the small piece you keep it on your slide, and just you keep another slide. Suppose this is the slide, just you imagine my hand is the slide, just you keep the chicken, the skin piece on the slide and keep the other slide and just smash it. Then smash it. Then what will happen is you just observe under the microscope. If you want, you can observe like that. Otherwise, you put a cover slip on that and observe under the microscope. So when you observe under the microscope, you will get this type of structure. You will get this type of structure. So here the skin contains layers. The skin contains the layers. We discuss in the sixth lesson. So this is how the cells are arranged uniformly. How the cells are arranged uniformly here. So this is called as the epithelial tissue. So depending upon the function, already I told you it is two types. One is squamous epithelium. Squamous epithelium. So what is squamous epithelium? If the epithelial tissue contains only one layer of cells, it contains only one layer of cells. You take our RBC, red blood cells, our lysosomes, ribosomes. So they are covered by only a single membrane. A single membrane. So this membrane is made up of epithelial cells. This is made up of epithelial cells. So this is called as the squamous epithelium. The epithelial cells which contains only one layer of cells, it is called as squamous epithelium. The second one is called as the stratified epithelium. So what is stratified epithelium? So the epithelial tissue which contains more than one layer. More than one layer is called as the stratified epithelium. They are observed in the skin. The skin contains epidermis and endodermis. Epidermis and endodermis means contains two layers. So if the epithelial tissue contains more than two layers, is called as the stratified epithelium. So stratified squamous epithelium. Each one layer is called, if one layer is present, it is called as the squamous. More than one layer, it is called as the stratified. So another one is called as the, this is the squamous epithelial tissue. And another one is called as the cuboidal epithelium. Depend upon the function and the shape. So this is the cuboidal epithelium. The squamous epithelium, the cells are very flat. You see the cells are very flat in the squamous epithelium. When you come to the cuboidal epithelium, they are cube shaped. They are like the cubes. This type of structures. So they are called as the cuboidal epithelium. So this type of epithelial tissue, you can observe the glands. Salivary glands, gastric glands, intestinal glands. So these glands contain this cuboidal epithelium, which helps for the secretion. They release salivary glands and release the saliva. Like that, the gastric glands release the gastric juices. So, but they help for the secretion purpose. Then the another one is called as the columnar epithelium. So we have the very, very cylindrical shape. Columnar epithelium. The cells are cylindrical. They are very long and cylindrical shape. So this type of structures you can observe in the intestinal walls. You can observe in the intestinal walls and the kidneys where the absorption takes place. You just in the willing, in the small intestine. Small intestine contains the finger-like structures. These finger-like structures are called as the willi, where the absorption takes place. So here it is lined with this columnar epithelium, and the cuboidal epithelium is present in the ureters. In the ureters, where the absorption will occur, secretion will be occurs. So this is about the different types of epithelial tissue. Different types of the epithelial tissue. Now we'll discuss about what are the main functions of the epithelial tissue. The first one, it offers protection. It protects the body parts from the external environment as well as from the invasion of microorganisms. Second one, it helps in the absorption process. And the third one, it helps from the secretion process also. So sometimes what may happen, this epithelial tissue, it may be folded. It may be folded. So it is cut up, this is, this may be, it occurs in the fold. So when it is occurs in the form of fold, then that is called as the glandular epithelium. It is called as the glandular. Is called as the glandular epithelium, where the epithelial tissue, it has fold. The layers, they may be sometimes they may be folded. So these folds are called as the glandular epithelium. So epithelial tissue, main function of the epithelial tissue, it offers protection. All the cell organelles, they are lined with the epithelial tissue. Already discussed in the first lesson, lysosomes, mitochondria, nucleus, Golgi complex, all are they lined with the outer membrane is nothing but the epithelial tissue. You have to consider that one. So there are different types of what are squamous epithelium, stratified epithelium, cuboidal epithelium, columnar epithelium, and the glandular epithelium. So these all are differentiate. How can you differentiate? Depending upon the structure. Depending upon the structure. If the cells are flat, it is called as squamous epithelium. If the cells are cube-set shape, it is called as cuboidal epithelium. If the cells are cylindrical, it is called as the columnar epithelium. So this is about your epithelial tissue. In the next class, we will discuss about the what are the connective tissue. What is connective tissue? We will discuss in the next class.